My topic is the future life supported by robotic operators, like these robots and this one. Okay, so I try to convince the why. Okay, so the Android. So this is okay, right? You understand what is that, right? But I'm more serious about this kind of minimal design of humans. I'm gonna convince you. In the near future, we're gonna accept this kind of a little bit creepy robots more. Right, this one. So this is our futures. We're gonna have more robots, more human-like robots, because our brain designed for recognizing human, not for computers, not for mobile phones. The human is the best interface for the human. Therefore, if we have enough technologies, we're gonna make this kind of features, right? Especially in Japan, maybe. However, there is a question. What is the idea design of robots? What is the ideal function of a robot? Okay, we need to carefully study about that kind of things. And however, difficulty is we cannot have a perfect knowledge about the human. Still, we are trying to develop a human-like robots. Okay, so that is the difficulties. And of course, the researchers in neuroscience and cognitive science, they are studying about the humans. But unfortunately, they do not have the global, the total ideas about the humans. They are focusing on the particular functions, just the limited parts of a brain. And they never give me a perfect sketch and a perfect design of a human, right? So my approach is, and to understand the human by building this kind of a robot. Once we try to make a perfect, try to make a very human-like robot, right? So we need to have some hypothesis about the human, mechanism of a human, okay? Then, by building the robots, so we can verify the hypothesis. That hypothesis can be used in the neuroscience and the cognitive science. So this is another approach to understand the humans. So we call this approach a constructive approach. So the question is, how much human likeness, human-like appearance do we need to give a robot? Or how about the human-like movement and human-like perception, the human-like conversational abilities? We didn't carefully need these topics so far, right? This is missing. Right, missing topics in science and engineering both. So I really think by building this kind of robots that we can deeply understand humans. So and I'm gonna show you a couple of questions and robots. Right. The first question is how much human likeness does a robot need to have? So in order to investigate that questions, I have built the very human-like robot in 2004. Actually, I have started my project in 2000 with my daughter. Right? And unfortunately, my daughter's Android was a little bit uncanny because I didn't have enough budget and I couldn't install enough number of actuators. Then when the robot moves, right? The body was, they're shaking like this. It looks like a zombie or something, right? However, this robot is much better, right? As you can see here, the mechanism is so human-like. This is a very complicated mechanism, and as you can see here, the robot can have facial expression. Of course, this guy also has a facial expression, but usually I don't laugh so much, so that today he looks a little bit serious. And so that is appearance, right? The human-like appearance, and the same time we need to install the human-like movement. So what is the most important human-like movement? So now you are sitting on the chairs, right? But your eyes and shoulders and bodies are slightly moving. That is a subconscious movement, right? So it's quite important to install that kind of the subconscious movement. And this guy also has a subconscious, right, and human-like movement. However, something different from the human. Okay, when the medical doctors, the specialist of a brain, and he said, "Oh, Professor Ishiguro, this is good. This is so human-like." However, somehow a little bit different from the real humans. Looks like a brain damaged person. Actually, We don't know how the human brain controls the body, right? And what I did is I just carefully measured the human movement by using a motion capturing system and developed the kind of a random computer program, right? But that is not enough, right? What we have to do is based on the model of how the human brain controls our bodies. So we need to develop the computer program for controlling the robots. So this is a collaboration with a neuroscientist. Now how about this, right? The robot has a very sensitive tactile sensor, right? And it's soft, the human-like skin, right? Therefore, the robot could have this kind of a reactive movement. However, this is also the very strange. Can you find what strange is this? Usually, the adult cannot answer these questions, but the children quickly answer to these questions. So today, there is no children, so that probably you don't understand why this is so strange. Right? Answer is if we tap the shoulder so many times, usually we get angry, but she never get angry, right? So that is the point, right? So what we have to do is we need to develop, we need to install the human-like mind. And in psychology, they have some ideas, how that we change the emotions, they have some models, right? So again, we have to work with a psychologist to improve this robot. So anyway, so this is a quite interdisciplinary approach. So this is not for the robotics. I mean the engineering, right? In order to improve this robot, we need to work with neuroscientists and cognitive scientists and psychologists. And that we can develop much better robot. And once we develop the robot is gonna be a test of it, as he said in the beginning, right? So far, right? Robot was in engineering, right? But after this, robot will be a science. Okay. So second question is, can we develop the autonomous intelligent androids? Of course, that this is a dream, kind of a dream, right? So, but if we carefully choose the situation and the purpose, I think we can do it. Human is quite situated. We cannot have, the general definition about humans. But if we carefully choose the purpose and situation, right, so we can make a very human-like robot. So the, I don't know that you have this kind of ideas. Now, he is a national treasure, living national treasure. We have that kind of idea in Japan. But he is the second the national treasure in the comic storytelling, rakugo in Japanese. Very, very important person, but he got old and he cannot play anymore. Then I and his son and his sponsor discussed the possibility to make him, android. So actually, this is good, right? So human-like. Now he got the eternal life, and this is much better than the videos. And we can enjoy, we can feel his presence, and we can enjoy very much. So the another application is show windows. I guess the elderly remember that original mannequin was so human-like, was like the wax model. However, recently the mannequin is not so the human-like. So, but with this android, we can go back to the original ideas. So this is much better than the other show windows. We can feel the real presence of the human, and we carefully develop the computer program to react to the visitors, the behaviors, and. Now this was so human-like, and she was very popular, right, in Japan. And then we went to the Hong Kong, right? Now in Hong Kong, we did a little bit of different things. In Hong Kong, what we did is she was singing a song. She was a kind of idol, right? So that probably, the Android is much better, because Android never complains, and Android can sing a song forever, right? So, yeah, we are seriously thinking to have an Android idol. And this is another, the ideas. The most difficult function for the Android is the conversation. In the noisy environment, the voice recognition never works. However, if we use the tablet computers. Actually, there are several tablet computers around Android. And if the visitor press the button on a tablet computer says something, and Android speak back. And then, you know, the visitor can have a feeling, you know, to talk with the Android, right? But the funny thing was that this is a, you know, department store, right? And, you know, the visitor, you know, became a kind of a friend of the Android, and everybody were very, very happy. And, you know, funny thing was that they wanted to buy the her clothes, the skirt and the scarf. This is not, it is not so cheap, right? About the $500, and this is the $200. But, you know, everything sold out quickly, right? You know, she's much better than the human, you know, well, the staff, and she can sell the many clothes. And then, you know, recently we are working with the champions, winners of a Robner Prize, you know, Laurel Carpenters. Do you know these ideas? You know, this Turing test, right? They're developing the very human-like chat, the computer program. The people are, they're chatting with the computer program, right? And if, you know, they didn't know what is that, right? And we can say that the computer program is almost the human, right? But if we combine that kind of a very intelligent computer and the chat computer program with our Android, so Android can have a kind of an autonomy to talk with the people, right? That this guy, you know, he likes her very much, and you know, and they're talking the many things. But the more funny things is, you know, if we install the same program into the robot and Android, so these guys, you know, can talk forever. So what we found, you know, look at this conversation. Are you human? Yes, I'm human. Are you robot? And, you know, these guys are talking, you know, something like that in my laboratories. This is scary, right? But it's very fun, okay? So, but this is the limitation. You know, basically we cannot develop the Android that talks like a human. So, but you know, if an Android has a very human-like appearance and movement, so we expect, you know, the Android can have, you know, the human-like conversational abilities. So how we can do that, right? So my idea is to prepare the tele-operated function, the function for the tele-operations. So here, the operator is watching two monitors. One is for visitors, one is for the Androids, their bodies, and you know, and he's just talking, right? And the computer analyzing his voice, and you know, they're controlling the lips, right? And sometimes, you know, the computer is tracking the operator's head, and you know, the computer is sending a command of head motion to the Android, and the head is moving. The operator can see some synchronization about the head movement and lip movement. And then, you know, the operator can adapt to this Android. Actually, the operator, you know, can accept this Android body as his own body. So I'm controlling here, but, you know, I'm not the best operators. The best operator is probably my secretaries, you know, some other, you know, my family members, right? They are always carefully watching my behaviors, you know, and they know that my behaviors, but I don't know my behavior. Right. So you don't know your behaviors because you know, you don't have a chance to carefully check your behaviors, right? But anyway, everybody can easily adapt to this Android and accept this Android as, you know, your own body. Of course, you know, the visitor, you know, can accept this Android as myself. And therefore, you know, I think this is another quite interesting experiment, right? If someone push a cheek, right? This is very bad for the operators, but you know, we have a very interesting phenomenon, right? Actually, you know, the operator can have you know, the very strong feeling to be touched, okay? So that is the adaptation of the operators. So this is his own body, imaginary. So anyway, so the operator and they use this Android, the Android will be his own body. So that is the power of this, you know, the tele-operated Android. So that means that we can transport our presence to the distant place by using this Android. So, and you know, I'm using this Android for giving my lectures. You know, I have two appointments, right? One is a university, the other is a research institute. So distance is about 2 hours by train, right? So every week I have to go there, but you know, a little bit troublesome. Therefore, you know, I'm using this one. But the problem is, you know, if I use this Android, so everything's there, right? So my appearance and movement and talking, everything's there, and the same as today. But of course, you know, he doesn't have a brain and you know, well, he doesn't have a stomach or something, right? But my question is, you know, did you check myself today? You know, nobody knows that, right? You know, you were just sitting, you know? So I didn't check your body, so you may be an Android, right? The problem is, you know, if I use this Android, the research institute says that they cannot pay for me. Why? Right? The probably in my stomach and the brain, well, maybe the stomach. Stomach is the earning the money, right? You know, it's very, well, the funny, that is very important, right? The how we can identify the persons. So once we, you know, develop this kind of robot and try to use the robot in the real world, so we can face to the very important philosophical questions. Of course, you know, that we can have a conference like this, right? And there were the Mansis, you know, he is giving a lecture in Europe and in the United States. And because, you know, I became very busy and, you know, and I'm getting so many offers about the conference talk. But this is quite convenient, right? And if we want, you know, that we can put the Android in their cafe and we can make many friends. This is a cafe restaurant. And you know, in Australia, Linz, okay? And I tele-operated this Android from Japan. But what is this? This is a kind of a big speakerphone. And usually we cannot use the speakerphones in a restaurant and a cafe. It's a very bad manner, right? But you know, nobody complains here, right? So that means that if you wanna use for example, in Japan, we cannot use the mobile phones in the public place. But you know, if we put this appearance to the mobile phone or speaker phone, we can use it everywhere. That is the power of a human-like appearance. If you wanna have a copy of this one, the price is about 100,000 US dollar. Not so expensive, right? It's the same as a luxury car. I strongly recommend you to buy this one. This is much safer, okay? You don't need to drive anymore, and you can exist many places simultaneously. So this is the technology. This is much better in the medias. So I'm replacing the people to the Androids one by one, you know. So far, I have replaced the three people, right? And maybe the five, up to five people, right? So next year, I'm gonna, you know, replace more than 10 people and 20 people, and someday, you know, I'm gonna replace everybody with Android. then you're gonna everybody can have eternal life. You don't need to worry about your age anymore, right? This is the ideal world, right? So, okay, let's move on to the next questions. Are the Androids more human-like than the humans? Yes, of course. Because you know that this is the technologies, so we can combine, you know, the best, the appearance and the best facial expression, the best movement and the best, you know, talking, right? So this is engineering. It's possible, right? So the most difficult part is the human-like the conversation, human-like talking. And if we develop if we make the Android theater, you know, the Android can have best appearance. The best talking, right? Everything is gonna be perfect. Actually, you know, the story of this theater is you know, that she's going to die soon. She's not Android. This is Android. Okay, you understand, right? And you know, that she's going to die soon. Therefore, you know, her daddy gave her this Android as a conversation partner. And these guys are talking about the human happiness. And the human, well, what is the human, right? What is the happiness, right? It's so dramatic, and she was so beautiful also, right? Because she is a kind of a perfect human. And then, you know, we went to the Linz again and played the theater in a church, in a cathedral, right? So usually, you know, we cannot play the church is just for the human, okay? So we cannot bring the robot into the church. But however, you know, we got a chance to pray that this theater in a church, right? And we got a pretty good reputation after that. Right. Now, you know, that we are traveling in the Europe and the United States with these annual researchers. So 2 months ago, I was here with these annual researchers. So this was a big success. But however, you know, we got another problem, right? She was so beautiful. And however, you know, the many people said, you know, and the human is not so beautiful, right? Human has some dirty aspect and something, you know. She's perfect. Therefore, you know, she looks like a Maria in the church. You know, my purpose is not to make her the God, right? My purpose is to make her, you know, the human-like android. So I needed to think again about the human likeness. So I would say the perfect android and human is not so human-like. What is more human-like? Probably the human interact with others by using imagination. Okay, human is so complicated, you know, that we need to, we identify the person that they based on appearance and movement and the snare and, you know, the voice and many things. Right? Roughly speaking, that we can have the imagination about the other person, other peoples. Okay, then probably, you know, if we, now this is a maximum the appearance, maximum design of a robot. I'm talking about the android. But this one is, you know, is a minimal design that maximizes the imaginations. Actually, this design works very well. Now, we cannot tell the age and gender and for this design, but you know, obviously this is a human, right? So once we hear the voice, and this is also the tele-operated system. Okay, once we hear the voice from this terenoid, we call that creepy robot the terenoid. You know, when we hear the voice from here, then we can have an imagination about the speakers. Then we mentally project that imagination onto this, neutral design. The idea works very well. And the elderly, especially elderly, and they are crazy for these ideas. And, you know, they know the exceptional case, you know, everybody loves to talk with this android. You know, it's pretty good, right? And then, you know, we started a new big project in Denmark. Denmark is a very famous the country for the welfare system. And you know, now we are very serious to develop the new communication media for elderly. If we give this robot to the elderly, they love to talk with android to the robot, and it's easy, and it is going to be a pretty good the exercise for them. At the same time, the medical doctor can check their healthy conditions. So this is a very serious project. So, and then, you know, I have decided to make, to deliver this design for everybody. So my idea is, to make, the mobile phone with this design. Actually, this is a mobile phone, right? So now everybody is using this, the black box, but everybody is talking to the black box. You know, as I said in the beginning of my talk, we don't have that kind of a brain function, right? The human-like stuff is much better for the human, okay? So therefore, the near future, so we're gonna see this kind of a scene, So mobile phone, we're gonna give a more meaningful shape to the mobile phones, the smartphones, and smartphone gonna be really smart, right? Okay, so eventually I got the email from the people, studying about the ancient clay figures. And actually, 5,000 years ago, we had the same, the design. This was a kind of a communicator with the dead people, right? We just went back to the very old in the world, right? With that design. So transhumanity, someday the boundary between the human and the machine disappears, right? I really think so, by accepting the new technologies. But, once we accept the new technologies, once we develop more human-like robots, so we're gonna have a more, everybody can have a chance to think about what is the humans, what is the heart and the mind. I think, this is our purpose. Why we are developing a robot, why we are developing, we are surviving in this world. So this is my motivation to study the robots. So this is my last slide, and please find the Android. in these videos. Okay, thank you very much.